Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier, and in our this particular video we will be looking somewhat in detail about dendrogram in MATLAB. Okay, so in my previous video I have discussed the basic idea of hierarchical clustering, like J2 core, A71, A51, A21, these different types of Galaxy, Samsung Galaxy phones are having some common features which are clustered as Samsung phone. Nokia phones have common feature of Nokia company, so they are clustered into Nokia. Then they are having common feature of mobile. Then in the other way, different kinds of TV have the common feature of TV, different kind of laptops have the common feature of laptop, and all these TV, mobile, laptops having common feature of electronic goods. So this is kind of hierarchical clustering. Small things which are having same property, we are basically combining them up, but in the bottom to top. Okay, so this is also called bottom-up approach, and this is just for the sake of one example I am showing. Practically, hierarchical clustering always occurs on binary level, that is only two childs are added and form a new cluster. Like here we have taken four childs and combined them into a cluster. This generally never happens. Like basically hierarchical clustering in dendrogram, always two childs are first merged. Okay, not like directly four child never merged. Okay, then we have seen that hierarchical clustering is a method which works via grouping data into tree of clusters, and here we have seen some example. Initially define all the points as individual cluster, then eventually form or cluster the closest pairs and form the dendrogram, where the height is basically showing us the distance or dissimilarity between two different clusters. So in y-axis basically we are plotting distance, right? So this is what is our dendrogram. And we have seen in MATLAB how to implement this particular graph, how to get this particular graph from data points. Alright, so now let me show you somewhat detailed concept related to dendrogram. Here I have taken one very small data set and the code is quite simple, CLC clear all close all. Then A equal to 0.40, 0.53, 0.22, 0.38. So these are basically X and Y coordinates respectively. 0.35, 0.32, 0.26, 0.19, 0.08, 0.41, 0.45 and 0.30. So this is my data set. I am implementing the linkage, that is I am creating hierarchical clustering tree, and single basically the calculating the distance in between one point and cluster, we are using single when we want to calculate the shortest path in between them. Okay, like here if you consider, when you are calculating distance between D and E and F, E and F has formed one single cluster, and when we want to calculate the distance between D and E and F, what will happen, we will be computing distance between D and E and D and F separately. The minimum of them we will be taking as distance between D and the cluster E and F. So for that you can give this particular argument single. You can check the linkage documentation, there it is clearly written. Then dendrogram tree figure. Alright, I will be now just simply implement this one, and I will be having the dendrogram like this. Now if you just write tree figure in your command window, I have shown you, you will be getting three columns matrix. So try to understand what is the relationship between this matrix and this particular figure. Okay, let us try to interpret. So first of all, these two first columns are basically indicating which clusters or which cluster and which links are basically connected. Like there are total six data points in our set, right? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right. So as they are unlabeled, so MATLAB is giving labeled like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So first of all, 3 and 6, these two objects, that may be customer income and spending score. Okay, so basically these 3 and 6 first merged because they are having minimum distance 0.1020, this one. Okay, now this particular link is given one name. Okay, so there are 6 objects, so total there are, after having 6 objects, so we have to give the name of the links. So links are given name like 7, 8, 9, 10, like that. So this particular link joining 3 and 6 will be given name as 7. Now 2 and this link are closest similarity, having similarity. So 2 and 7 are merged, okay? 7 is basically this link formed in between 3 and 6, and the distance is 0.1432. So this particular link is formed, and this particular link name is given 8, because 7 after that 8 will be formed. Then 5 and 8, that is 5, this particular object, and the 8 is having similarity. So they are merged and they are forming one new link, this one, which is given the name 9. Then 9 and the object 4 having similarity. So they are forming one more link, which is 10. And 10 and 1 are basically merged, or which are having distance 0.2159 and having forming this one. Alright, so like this dendrogram is basically formed. Alright, as the distance is more between two links, it indicates more dissimilarity. And it is not only that, always the connection will be formed in between objects. See here, like 2 is linking with 7. Here you can see 2 is linking with 7, where 7 is not an object, it is basically one link. Alright, now with the basic simple idea, I want to discuss one concept related to the data set which we have used earlier. So here this is our previous code which we have implemented. Thus, let me clear this, then import the data set. I'll be going to home tab and here now we can import the data. I'll be going to desktop and data. I'll be taking data.csv file, which is our this one. Now I'll click on this green color tick button, and then I'll be taking 4th and 5th column, which is having the salary of the customers and their spending score. We'll be checking null value is present or not. Alright, then we'll be basically performing feature scaling algorithm, that is standardization we are applying here, and then we are converting from table to array, because table input is not valid for linkage inbuilt function, and then we are plotting the dendrogram. So if I plot that, I'll be having this dendrogram. Now this linkage, whatever you are observing here, it may not that these all are basically objects, okay? This may be links also. Like here, if I just simply write tree figure, let me just clear this, and here let me just increase the comment window so that you can clearly observe. See here, initially between 66 and 69 distance is 0, 49 and 50 distance is 0, 130 and 132 distance is 0. So 0 distance cannot be shown in dendrogram, right? So it is not necessary that what you are observing here, those are only objects. It is possible that in the just below part, the part which is at the minimum level, that also maybe one link. It is not necessary that will be one object, because 0 distance will make one link, but that link cannot be shown in the dendrogram. So it is possible that these are links also. Okay, so this is what I wanted to show you. Now in my next video, I'll be showing how you can find optimal number of clusters required for clustering this particular unsupervised learning. Like here we have done clustering, right? Along with dendrogram, here we have started clustering. Now how many clusters required? Whether 2, 3, 4, 5. How we can calculate using this dendrogram, that I will be discussing in my upcoming video. Thank you for watching.